Hey there, Jeff Fritz here again, and I want to talk to you today about Blazor components. Now, all of our files in a Blazor project that have the .razor extension are components. Now, some of those components we can reach by navigating to an address in our browser. Some of those we can reuse inside of other pages and components so that we can access them, we can reuse their content. Let's take a look at what we can do with components, how we turn them into pages in this video, and how we can pass a parameter into our components so they become a little bit more like an HTML tag or a directive, as we refer to them sometimes when we're building with those various web development frameworks. Here we are inside of our first Blazor app. This is the result of the default template for a Blazor server application. And I'm looking at the index.razor file. We see what looks like a pretty standard Razor template. Hello world, welcome to your new app. How is Blazor working for you? Wait a sec. The survey prompt tag that we see there, that's not an HTML tag. That's not a directive that I'm familiar with. Where does that come from? That's a component. It's highlighted in bold purple here inside of Visual Studio, and I can see on the left side inside of Solution Explorer, there is a survey prompt Razor file. In our Blazor applications, any file that ends with a .razor file extension is a component that can optionally be referenced inside of another component. So if we look at survey prompt Razor, there's the content of our survey prompt element that'll be rendered where we saw the survey prompt tag here on line 7. So we can reuse some of the other content that's shown here with .razor files that we find in our Solution Explorer. Let's run this application and tinker with some of these and see what else we can reuse as a component inside of our index page. So there's my application running on the right side in Microsoft Edge. And over here on the left, I have Visual Studio, and I can start tinkering with that index page and see what exactly lights up when I reference various components using their file name as a tag inside my index page. So let's try adding a counter. And I'll save that. On the right side, my browser will refresh, and now the counter page is embedded inside of my index over on the right side. That's interesting. Okay, I can even put the fetch data element in here, and we'll get the fetch data page output inside of my browser there on the right side. Now, in this case, these aren't very valid samples. They aren't something that I really want to embed inside of my index page on the right. But we can do some things to make it a little bit more interesting and reuse and show off some of these features. Let's start with taking a look at that title attribute that we see on the survey prompt. That's a title that's being passed in. It's some text that's being submitted into the survey prompt component and being rendered inside of our index page on the right side in the middle of that div that shows how is Blazor working for you. Okay, maybe we can add an attribute to our counter that allows me to change the incrementing count of the counter there. So instead of it incrementing by ones, we can increment by some other value. How do we do that? How do we start passing that information into our page and into our counter.razor component? So I'm going to go over to counter.razor, and here in this code block that defines the code that's being executed for the counter, and we can see here there's an onClick event handler that is calling increment count, and that increment count is right here. It increments a current count field right here that's being output right there inside of the current count paragraph. So if I want to add an attribute that's going to change this from incrementing by one here to increment by some other value. We can add a property, a public property, called increment by, and I'll set a default value of 1 to that, and I'll update my method here to plus equals increment by. We'll use that increment operator to increment and assign by the increment by value, which for right now is defaulting to the value 1. Okay. I want to make that property something that can be assigned, something that's being passed in from my index page. So to do that, to complete the cycle here, I just decorate this with the attribute parameter. And that will make increment by a parameter that can be specified inside of other components, inside of pages that we want to control how the counter behaves. So I'll save the counter here, and it's going to refresh on the right side, and it still increments by 1 because that's the default value being assigned to the increment by property right here. I'll go up to index, and now inside of my counter element, I'll add a space and start typing increment by, and you see Visual Studio is giving me some help. It's telling me there's an increment by attribute here that you can assign. And if you look closely there, you'll see it's got the little at sign next to increment by. It's telling us that this is a C# attribute that we're specifying and we're passing a value into our component. So I'll specify increment by 5, save that. It's going to refresh my application. And now when I click the button, it increments by 5s. If I go over to the counter page where I have just the counter element appearing here, I'll click and it still increments just by 1s because that increment by property is not being assigned a different value. So I can control the behavior two different ways by interacting with this parameter, by setting it and consuming it appropriately in different locations. This gives us a way now that we can interact with components, reuse them, take them from more than just a page or the only entry on a page, and reuse them in multiple places throughout our Blazor application. I hope you stick around for our next video. We're going to talk about now how we can do more with the pages inside of Blazor, how we can take them and start to define how we receive and control what URL they're listening to and the layout that they're behaving inside of, the layout that they're presented inside of. Thanks so much.